So this is not about making things 100 times faster, 100 times bigger, 100 times more futuristic. This is about making things 100 times simpler, 100 times cheaper, 100 times more inclusive. My name is Bill Thies, and I'm a researcher at Microsoft Research India. So I work at the intersection of technology and global development. We try to make technology more accessible and useful to very low-income populations, and to see if technology can amplify the impact of organizations who are working on their behalf. We have a project called 99 Dots, which helps to ensure that every tuberculosis patient makes a full and complete recovery. One of the major challenges is that to make a full recovery from tuberculosis, you have to take medication for a full 6-month treatment period. And many patients start to feel better after just the first few weeks. So how do you convince someone with a very limited education that you feel better, but still you have to take toxic medication for the next 5 or 6 months? It's a very challenging thing. With 99 Dots, every blister pack is wrapped in a custom package, and when patients dispense medication, they reveal a hidden phone number behind every dose. They use a basic mobile phone to place a free phone call to that number, and that gives us enough information to show that that person has that dose of medication in their hand on a given day. And other researchers have shown that if the pills are in your hand, it's very likely swallowed. CG Netswara is a voice-based citizen journalism platform in rural central India. What you find in very rural areas is that there's not a lot of presence of mainstream media. These communities are very remote. They're very difficult to travel to. What we did think, though, is that increasingly there are mobile phones in these areas, very basic mobile phones, but people have access to mobile phones. Can we use mobile phones to let people report their own stories in their own language and in their own voice? And so using this system, people can pick up a phone, they make a phone call, they record a short message about a local event or maybe a problem which is bothering them. And what happens is there's a team of trained moderators with a journalist at the helm who reviews these stories, makes sure they're appropriate, and then publishes them. Once they're published, they appear on an internet website, and they also appear on the same phone line. So people from the community and from outside can call in and listen to those stories. And often, they take action based on what they heard. So they see there's a problem in a local school. They bring that to the attention of the local official who can fix that problem. I think this recognition from the MacArthur Foundation can really inspire the next generation of students and scholars to think about the role of technology in global social challenges. And you know, it's not just about me. There's a whole community of people working on similar problems in similar spaces. And many of them are anonymous, working day and night in rural areas. And I would love at least part of this award from the MacArthur Foundation to help enable this community to innovate in new directions.